It's kind of a preview. We'll be doing more of this on Thursday. We know the frontal bone, but I haven't talked about the ethmoid. Ethmoid is, a lot of it's involved with sense of smell. Do you see where it's located? Right above the nasal sinus. So it kind of makes sense. The word olfactory means smell. Olfactory. So these little holes are olfactory foramen. Or really foramina, for plural. Olfactory foramina. And all together, this area of all the holes is called cribriform plate, which also kind of means holes. So the holes are olfactory foramina. The entire structure is cribriform plate. And here's the comb of the rooster, Crista galli. And it looks like the comb of the rooster. It's where the membranes of the brain have a place to attach. So that's the ethmoid, kind of small. The bigger bone in the cranial floor is the sphenoid. And it's a keystone because it's in contact with most of the major bones. So there's the lesser wings here, lesser wing, and here's the greater wings of the sphenoid. Sphenoid is very busy because we have the hypophyseal fossa here, and that's where a gland, the pituitary gland, sits right in there. See how the body protects it? It's such an important gland that it has a special little pocket right there. And then this whole thing is called the sella turcica, turkey saddle, looks like a saddle. And here's the holes. When you're looking, when you're on a test, okay, you want to think of where you are, because if you're looking for holes down here, you can get messed up. So you find the sella turcica, and you go, right there is the rotundum. And then you drop down to the oval-shaped hole, that's the ovale. Then you go inside here, lacerum, and this little spiny hole, spinosum. Yeah, so it's pretty easy where students get messed up as they start looking down here. And these are different holes. That's a carotid, excuse me, that's the jugular, that's the, anyway, so think of where you are. Rotundum, ovale, lacerum, spinosum.
Those are all going to have the word form in front of them.
Foramen.
Foramen.
Yeah, okay. if they're a fill-in, then you have to call them foramen ovale.
Okay.
Foramen rotundum. This is the occipital. There is a couple holes. We learned the external occipital condyle, external ear opening. We have an external auditory canal. Internal auditory canal here, and then there's a weird canal here called the hypophyseal canal, and it's an important nerve right here. Hypophyseal canal, it's within the foramen magnum. There's the occipital condyles, styloid process, mastoid. What else is back there? What's the name of this? Oh, we have, oh no, this is next time, never mind. Okay, got it.
Quick question.
Yeah.
The Vomer bone, or the Vomer bone.
Vomer, you know, Vomer.